Have you ever wanted to add an interactive table of contents to your videos to make them easier for your viewers to navigate? Or do you want to make your editing process more efficient? If the answer is yes, then markers are a great tool for you to use. Markers essentially serve as placeholders on your timeline and media. They can be used to help you lay out edits you need to make without having to preview your video over and over. They can also be used to quickly set up an interactive table of contents when you produce your video. When you're in the editor, you can access the marker view by opening the Marker Quiz drop-down menu to the left of the timeline and selecting Show Marker View. You can also go back and choose Hide Marker View to close the marker view when you're not using it. If you like to save even more time by using hotkeys, you can use the hotkey Ctrl+M to either show or hide the marker view. Now, you can see here that I already have two markers on my project. These represent the two different kinds of markers that you can create. The first is a global marker, and the second is a media-based marker. Global markers are attached to a specific point in the timeline and are marked with a green diamond-shaped indicator. Because the marker is attached to the timeline itself, it's independent of anything that goes on down in the tracks. So if I move any of this media or make other changes to the tracks, the global marker is going to stay in the same spot. Now, the media-based marker is marked with a blue diamond-shaped indicator, and it's attached to a specific point on a piece of media. This can be your screen recording, your audio, callouts, images, any piece of media on any of the tracks in your project. Because it's attached to a piece of media, any time that piece of media is moved, the marker will go with it. Now, to add a marker, I need to move my cursor over any of the marker bars, either above the timeline for a global marker or above a piece of media for a media marker. Anywhere I see a diamond indicator appear, I can click to add a marker. When I add a marker, I can immediately change the name of the marker to help me remember what it's for. For example, if I want to mark a section for deletion, I can add a marker at the beginning of the section and name it Start Delete, and then add a second marker at the end of the section and name it End Delete. Then, when I'm ready to delete that section, all I have to do is double-click the first marker's thumbnail to move the playhead to that marker, and then select the area between the two markers. There are two other ways to add markers. One is to use the hotkey M. This is going to add a global marker to the point where the playhead is on the timeline. It'll also open the marker view if it's not already open. The second is to add markers while you're recording. To do this, you can either select Add Marker from the recorder or use the hotkey Ctrl+M. When you save and edit the recording, those markers will be added as media-based markers on the screen recording. This can be a great way to mark the beginning of a new topic or mark a mistake that you know you'll want to edit out later while it's still fresh in your mind. These markers won't have a name, so to edit the name of any marker, just right-click on the marker's thumbnail and choose Rename. Or if the marker already has a name, just double-click on the existing name to edit it. Next, to get rid of a marker, all I have to do is click on the marker's thumbnail and press the Delete key. Or I can right-click and choose Delete. I can also right-click and choose Delete All to get rid of all the existing markers on the project. This can be useful if you've used a lot of markers while editing and want to start with a blank slate to create a table of contents. Let's do that now and delete all the markers to create a table of contents. A table of contents is made up of all the existing markers on the timeline. When it's produced, it'll look like this for your viewers. An easy way to add a table of contents is to start at the beginning and scrub or play your way through the video. When you get to the beginning of a new section, press M to add a global marker, and then give it a name that will tell viewers what to expect from that section. Continue this way through the rest of your video. When you're finished, click the Produce and Share button. Here, you can choose any option that will produce your video with a smart player, including ShareToScreencast.com, either of the MP4 with video player options, or the custom production settings, as long as you choose to produce with the MP4 Flash HTML5 player option. The other available options don't include the smart player, which is required to have a table of contents. If you continue through the custom production settings, you'll find a page called Marker Options in the production wizard. Here, you can decide how you want your table of contents to appear and make any last-minute changes to your marker names. If you choose any of the other options, your table of contents will be set automatically based on the names you've given your markers. When you produce your video, viewers will be able to find the table of contents by clicking this button in the player. They can then easily navigate to any of the sections you've marked by clicking on that item in the table of contents. We've covered just a couple of ways for you to use markers. Try them out for yourself and let us know of any great uses you come up with here at feedback.techsmith.com. Thanks for watching.